In this episode of Minute GarageBand, we're going to show you how to split a single stereo track into two separate tracks. If you've used two mics or even two DIs to record a pair of vocals, guitars, or say a kick and snare onto a single stereo track, you may find that you want more control over the mixing of them. For instance, being able to use different EQ settings for one while not affecting the other with the same settings. In this example, we have two lead guitars, each recorded on a single channel of a stereo track, one left and one right. While GarageBand itself doesn't offer a method for splitting up the channels of a single track, it's not difficult and we can use iTunes to do the job. Open iTunes and then open its preferences. Click Import Settings, choose AIFF Encoder from the Import Using pop-up menu, and then Custom from the Settings pop-up menu. Make sure the sample rate is 44.1K, the sample size is 16-bit, and set the channels to mono, then close the prefs and return to GarageBand. Set the tracks pan fully left and export using Song to iTunes via the Share menu. Then set the pan fully right and again export to iTunes. The next step is to let iTunes convert our one-sided stereo files into mono files so that the sound will come from both speakers. Control-click one of the files, and if you've set iTunes preferences as we did, pick Create AIFF Version from the pop-up menu. Now repeat this process for the other file. We set up a smart playlist so that we could easily find our newly created files, and when we open that, we find that along with our original exports, we have two new mono copies of those files which we can drag and drop back into GarageBand. Now each guitar is on its own track, ready to be panned, EQ'd, and affected as desired. That's all we have for this episode. We hope you found it useful. And for more, subscribe to our YouTube channel. So long.
Quick, Jane, turn on headlights. Snake caught in grass.